Good morning to all my dear students and welcome to Zoology Online class. So today, this is the last class for the animal tissue. I try to finish the total nervous system, that is nervous tissue today. Clear? So let me start, that is the nervous tissue. Let me start the nervous tissue. So first of all, that is in the previous class I had completed, that is the muscle tissue, and the remaining substance which I have not taught you, that is the fluid connective tissue. And the fluid connective tissue I will teach you at the time of circulatory system. So let me start, that is the nervous tissue. So in the previous class, or first of all, we know that is a group of cells having the same origin, same development, and performing the same function is called as the tissue. Clear? The tissue is of four types. First of all, that is the epithelial tissue, where the cells are arranged very closely without having intercellular space, just above the basement membrane, and they form the surface layer. They are called as the epithelial tissue. Then after, that is the where cells are present, that is distantly, having a large gap among them, that is called as the intercellular space, and which is filled with a fluid-like substance called as the matrix, where the matrix is more and the cells are less, and these cells and the matrix having the fibers, they are called as the connective tissue. Clear? And under the connective tissue, we had read, that is the connective tissue proper, skeletal connective tissue, which we have not read, that is called as the fluid connective tissue. Clear? Then after, the muscle tissue, that is the tissue, or it consists of the cells, elongated cells having the ability to contract and relax. Clear? And that is the arrangement of the muscle cells. Here there is no intercellular fluid or matrix. Similarly, we will come, that is the epithelial tissue forms the surface layer. They are closely packed over the basement membrane, and that is the connective tissue, where the intercellular space is present with, that is the presence of matrix. And the muscle, where the cells having the capacity to contract and relax. But what is the characteristics of the nerve cell? What is the characteristics of the nervous tissue? The nervous tissue, or the tissue which receives the information and transfer the impulse, or that is the transmit the message from one part of the body to the other part, is called as the nervous tissue. The tissue which receives the information and transmit the message from one part of the body to the other part is called as to the other part of the body, that is, or the which transfer the message to the other part of the body is called as the nervous tissue. Clear? Then, in otherwise, we can say that is the nervous tissue comprises of the cells which has the capacity to, or which has the ability That is the excitability as well as the conductivity. That is the excitability and the conductivity. Excitability and that is the conductivity. So these two, that is the properties that is are present in the tissue having, or they are the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue must bear or must bear the two properties. One is excitability, another is the conductivity. You know, in the previous class I had taught you what is the excitability. Excitability is the ability of the cell to receive the information, and according to that they have to, that is response to it. Clear? Or you can say that excitability is the ability of initiate the nerve impulse. In case of the nervous tissue, that is, it have the ability to initiate the nerve or to initiate the nerve impulse. And the conductivity is the property where, that is, the cell transmit that impulse from one part of the body or from, that is, to the other part of the body. That is ability to transfer that in the form of nerve impulse. Are you understanding me or not? That is, one is excitability, another is the conductivity. Excitability is the ability to, that is, the receive and to respond the, that is, the stimulus, or that is the initiate or the ability to initiate the nerve impulse. In case of the nervous tissue, it is the ability to initiate the nerve impulse. Otherwise, the excitability, the meaning of excitability is the ability to receive and to respond the stimuli. That is called as the excitability. But in case of the, that is, the nervous, in the, that is, the, in the sense of nervous tissue, or in the, that is, the in place or in case of the nervous tissue, it is the ability to initiate the nerve impulse. And the conductivity is the property of the nerve tissue to transfer that nerve impulse, that is, in a forward direction or into the other part of the body. So this is called as, that is, the, and the cells having these two property must, or they are under the nervous tissue. Clear? Then we will start, that is, the, we will start, the nervous tissue is ectodermal in origins. We know that is epithelial tissue, they originate from three germ layer: ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. But the connective tissue develops only from the mesoderm, and the, that is, the muscle tissue, they develop from the, that is, the mesoderm, except the iris as well as the ciliary muscles, which are ectodermal in nature. And that is the nervous tissue, they are purely ectodermal. Only that is the microglial cell, the microglial cells are mesoderm. Otherwise, that is the nervous tissue, mainly it is ectodermal in nature. And the, there is no intercellular space among the, that is, the nerve tissue. There is no intercellular space among the, that is, the nervous tissue. It is widely distributed in the body of the individual to maintain, or which maintains, that is, or that is the, it is, that is, it is present all over the body and maintains the coordination among the body parts, among the body parts. Then in man, it is about 2.4% of the total body weight. In the man, it is about 2.4% of the total body weight. Nerve cells occur, the nerve cells occurs, that is, the nerve cell occur in almost all the, that is, multicellular individuals, except the sponges, except the sponges. But in case of the cylindrates, like that is the, for example, the hydra, that is like the, that in the cylindrates, that is the, for example, in hydra, they are simplest one. They are most simplest one. Clear? Then, the another thing is, nerve cells are the largest cell in our body. The nerve cells are the largest cell in our body, but they have no capacity to divide. But they have, they cannot divide themselves, because the in the mature nerve cell, the centrioles are absent, or the centrosome is absent. Clear? For that reason, that is, the nerve cells cannot divide. Clear? Then you come to, that is the nervous tissue. The nervous tissue, that is the nervous tissue, forms the, that is the nervous system. The nervous tissue form the nervous system, and the nervous, that is the nerve tissue, consists of four types of cell. The nerve tissue consists of the four types of cells. The nerve tissue the nervous tissue not nerve tissue that is the nervous tissue the nervous tissue comprises of the four types of cell. First of all, you come to the neurons, and the second is neuroglia, and the third is, that is your ependymal cells. And the last one is the neurosecretory cells. Neurosecretory cells. The first one is called as the, that is the neurons, and another three, they are the neuroglia, ependymal, and neurosecretory cells. So first of all, you come to the neurons, and among the four types of cells, the neuron is the most important, as because it is the structural and functional unit of the nervous tissue. It is the structural and functional unit of the nervous tissue, where the neuroglia, ependymal cell, as well as the neurosecretory cell, they support as well as the protect the neuron, as well as the protect the neuron. So today, that is, I will, and this one is most important, the neuron, the structure and function and the types of neuron is the most important, and these are very negligible, but they behaves as the connective tissue and they protect the neurons. Clear? So that is, I will discuss, that is the detail about the neurons. Clear? Neurons is the structural and functional unit of the nervous tissue. Clear? And the neuron is the nerve cell. Mainly, that is the nerve cell mean, or the neuron is the nerve cell. So first of all, you come to the structures of the neuron. The structure of the neuron. The neuron is divided. Neuron is divided into two parts. One is the cell body, or we can say that is called as the cyton. That is called as cyton, cell body or cyton. And another is called as the neurites, and another is called as the neurites. That is, the first one is called as the cell body, cyton, and another is called as the neurites. So nerve cells, I have told you, nerve cells are the largest cell in the body, and it is large and granulated cell. It is a large and granulated cells. So that is the nerve cell. Nerve cell is otherwise called as the neuron. The neuron is the large and granulated cells, and mainly having two parts. One is the cell body, that is the cell body, which is otherwise called as the cyton. And the neurites. Neurites means that is just above the or just surrounding the cyton, the small projection which arise from the cyton, they are totally called as the neurites. They are all the called as the neurites. Tamane jete guda ko branch bahari chi e cell body ru se guda ko total ko agala neurites. But eti di prakara bahari chi branch guta huchi chuta guta huchi gudae chuta guta huchi bodo. And these small branches are called as the dendrites. These are called as the dendrites, and the long branch is called as the axon. Previously, Previously, it was called as this large branch is called as the dendron, and the small branches are called as the dendrites. But nowadays, the small branches are called as the dendrites. Clear? And the cytoplasms, and this that is first you come to the cyton. Cyton is the cell body of the neuron, where a large nucleus is at the center. Of the cell body or the cyton, and it contains the nacelles granules and neurofibrils. I have told you the cytoplasm is much more granulated, and it contains the nacelles granules. And the neurofibrils. Clear? These are the neurofiber-like structure. These are called as neurofibrils. Clear? And these nacelles granules and neurofibrils are present along with other cytoplasmic organelles of the cyton, or inside the cytoplasm. That is the Golgi body, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, and the mitochondria. They are all present inside the cytoplasm, and that cytoplasm is called as the neuroplasm. Neuroplasm. And this neuroplasm contains the granules, large granules called as the nacelles granules, and some fiber-like structure called as the neurofibrils. And the nacelles granules, it is assumed that the nacelle granules are large, which are the Golgi bodies as well as the endoplasmic reticulum. Which are the mass of the endoplasmic reticulum. So it is supposed, and it is rich with the RNA. So it is supposed, or it is assumed that the nacelles granules helps in the protein synthesis. They help in the protein synthesis. And the neurofibrils, which are appear as a fiber-like structure inside the neuroplasm, they helps in the transmission of the impulse. Clear? But it has no centrioles, or it has no centrosome. That means the centrosomes are absent, so these neurons cannot divide. So its regenerating power is very less. Clear? Then you come to the second one, is called as the neurites. Then you come to the neurites. The neurites are the branching process which arise from the side turn is are called as the neurites. It is of two types. Some are small and only one is a large one. These small branches are called as the dendrites, and the long branch is called as the axon. The long branch is called as the axon. Clear? The dendrites contains, that is the dendrites are fine, that is narrow, and that is branching process or much more branched. Clear? And they that either may attach with the end of or the end of the axon, or they are attached into the sense organs or into the sensory cell. So where they attach with the or joins with the, that is the ending of the axon, this is the ending of axon, telodendria, and that junction is called as the synapse. That junction is called as synapse, with a gap that is about 200 angstrom. That is with a gap that is about 200 angstrom. Then that is the end. That is another is, that is it may either attest with the last end of the axon, or it is attached with the sensory cells or the sense organ of the individual. So it helps to receive or it helps to bring the impulse from the, that is the sense organ, into the cyton. So it is otherwise called as the efferent process. It is called as the efferent process. It is otherwise called as the efferent process. Clear? So, and inside in the, that is the cytoplasms of the dendron contains both nacelles granules and neurofibrils along with the other cytoplasmic organelles. Then you come to the, that is the third one, that is called as the axon. The third one is the axon. The axon is the large and thick, uniformly thick branch which arise from the cyton is called as the axon. It is the large branch, and its length sometimes may reach up to 1 meter. Its length sometimes may reach into 1 meter. Clear? So for that reason, it is the largest cell in the body, and the point at which it arises, it is called as the axon hillock. Axon hillock. And that axon hillock is the most important and most sensitive part of the, that is the cyton. And for that reason, it is called as the trigger zone, or the trigger zone of the cyton. It is for which it is called as the trigger zone of cyton. Then after, that is, it contains only the neurofibrils. Then it contains only the neurofibrils, no nacelles granules, no, that is the ribosomes, as well as no, it contains only the neurofibrils, much more neurofibrils along with the, that is the mitochondria. It has no fat bodies, it has no ribosomes, and it has no other cytoplasmic organelles. Clear? It mainly helps to transmit the impulse from, that is the cyton, into the other, or into the, that is other part. So it is otherwise called as the efferent process. Efferent process. It is called as the efferent, but it is called as the efferent process. In certain, that is the axon, that is a side branch may arise. Side branch may arise, and that is called as the collateral branch. That is called as the collateral branch, and it arises at a, or it develops, that is perpendicularly over the axon or over the main axon. And the last branching process of the axon is called as the telodendria. Telodendria. And sometimes the telodendria forms a small knob-like structure called as the presynaptic knob. Presynaptic
nerve, which contains the mitochondria and secretory vesicle. Which contain the mitochondria and the secretory vesicle. And the secretory vesicle secretes the neurotransmitter like acetylcholine for the transmission of that is the impulse from that is the one ending of the axon to the beginning of the dendrites. Clear? Always you have to remember that dendrites actually always receives the impulse and axon has to discharge the impulse. It receives the impulse and discharge the impulse. That is the ending of the axon discharge the impulse, but here the beginning of or the dendrites always receives the impulse. Clear? So this is about the axon. Clear? Then after you above that, and this neuroplasm, that is the neuroplasm which is present inside the axon, is called as the exoplasm. Exoplasm. And the membrane which covers the axon is called as the exolemma. Exolemma. And inside which only the neurofibrils along with the mitochondria are present. Clear? Then you come to the types of neuron. This is all about the neuron or the nerve cell. I have told you the nervous tissue comprises of four different types of cells. One is the neuron, another is the neuroglia, another is the ependymal cell, and another is the neurosecretory cells. And among them, the neuron is the important one, and they are the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Otherwise, that is your neuroglia and the ependymal cell and the neurosecretory cells, they are supporting the neurons as well as they are protecting the neurons. Clear? So our aim is to read perfectly over the neurons. So the neuron is the structural and functional unit of the nervous tissue. Clear? And the nervous tissue forms the nervous system. Clear? And the neuron is the cell, or the neuron is the nerve cell, the structures of the neuron. It is the largest cell in the body, and the structure can be studied under two headings. One is the cell body, another is the neurite. Cell body is the swelling portion of the cell which contains the nucleus. Then the neurites are the branching process which develops from that cell body. And these neurites are of two types. One is make many small projections. They are called as the dendrites, and a single large projection that is called as the axon. The dendrites always they are the fine thread like structure, branching thread like structure, who always they receives the impulse. It may ends near the ending of axon and forms a junction called as the synapse. Clear? With a gap of 200 angstrom. Otherwise, it can receive or it is connected with the sensory organs, and through which the impulse travels from the sensory organ or the sensory organ to the cyton. So these are called as the efferent process. Similarly, the large projection which arises from the cyton is called as the axon. And inside exoplasm, only the neurofibrils are present along with the mitochondria. Clear? And the covering or the layers which is present over it, they are called as the exolemma. And the axon end with the branching process called as the telodendria. The end of the branching process swells and it forms the presynaptic nerve, and these nerves or the terminal bottom and which contains the mitochondria, especially the mitochondria, and that is the secretory vesicle. The secretory vesicle secretes the neurotransmitter like that is the acetylcholine. Then after the
then this is all about the, that is the neuron. Then you come to the types of neuron. How many types of neurons are there? That is mainly, that is the neurons are divided into many branches depending upon two things. One is the structure, another is the function. One is the structure, another is the function. You first divide the neuron into the, according to their structure, you first come to the, that is the division of the neuron according to their structure. One is, that is, it is divided, the structurally, the neurons are divided into five categories, You first come to the number one, that is a non-polar neurons, that is called as the non-polar neurons. In case of the non-polar neurons means, here it is very primitive types of neurons, where it is much more branched one. Having so many small branches without recognition of, that is the dendrites as well as the axon. That is helps in both the processes, like, or it behaves in both the process, that is called as the efferent as well as the efferent. It can bring the impulse, and it also can transmit the impulse from the cell body to the outside. So this type of, that is the non-polar neurons are present in the, that is the Hydra, is present in the, or simplest type of neurons which are present in case of the Hydra, in case of the cylindrids. Here, that means here many branches are present, or the neuron bears many small projections or branches without the recognition of axon and dendrites. Clear? And all the branch, or each branch, can behaves as efferent and efferent. So this is a primitive type of neuron which is found in case of the Hydra. So this is all about the non-polar neuron. Then the second one is called as the, that is called as the unipolar neurons. Unipolar neurons, uni means a single, polar nucleus, that means here only one projection is that is present, and that is axon. That is the neuron having only one projection, that is called as the axon. Clear? And that is only one axon is present there. Clear? Then another thing is, that is, this type of neurons are found in the early embryonic stage of the invertebrates and the vertebrates. Clear? Then the third category is called as pseudo unipolar neurons. Pseudo unipolar neurons. Pseudo means, you know, pseudo means false. Unipolar means single projection. Pseudo means false, and unipolar means single projection. So this is the cyton, and the cyton having a one projection, and that projection is divided into axon and dendrites. One dendrites and another is axon, that is, this is one projection and this is cyton. So pseudo unipolar neuron means, pseudo means false, unipolar means single pole, single projection. So that neuron contains a single projection, and after that it is divided into two part, one is dendrite and another is axon. So here the dendrite and axon appear same. Clear? And this is called as the pseudo unipolar, that is the neurons. Then you come to the fourth one, is called as the bipolar neurons. Bipolar neurons, that is, bi means two. Here the cell body having two, that is the projections.
One is axon, another is dendrites. One is axon, another is dendrites. And this type of neurons are found in the retina of the eye and the epithelium of, that is the retina of the eye and the, that is the olfactory epithelium of the olfactory chamber. Olfactory epithelium. Olfactory means what are you doing? Ghana subject in the naco. Hala naco with the olfactory chamber, olfactory membrane. Hala, so to brain kujaichi, olfactory nerve. So this is called as the bipolar, having one dendrites and one axon. And you come to the last category, that is called as the multipolar. Multipolar. Multipolar means multipolar neurons. Multi means many. Multipolar means many. And this type of neurons are common in our brain and spinal cord. Here, that is having so many dendrons, but the axon is one. The axon is one. Always the axon is one, but the number of dendrites is variable. Is variable. It may be one or it may be more. So in this way, this is called as the multipolar neuron. So depending upon the neurons are classified into so many groups. First of all, that is depending upon the structure, it has five varieties. One is nonpolar neuron, having no, that is the axon and dendron. There are many branches, but there is no recognition which one is axon and which one is dendron, dendrites. Similarly, unipolar, only one axon is present, that is no dendrites. In pseudo unipolar, one projection arises from the, that is the neuron, and it is again divided into two parts, one dendrite and one axon. In bipolar, that is one axon and one dendrite. But in multipolar, many more dendrites and only one axons. And this is all about, that is the types of neuron. This is all about the types of the neuron depending upon the structure. Then you come to the, that is depending upon their function. That is depending upon their function, depending upon their function. Depending upon their functions, there are three types. First one is called as the sensory or efferent neurons. Are you understanding a neuron? Neuron is the nerve cell. That is here the nerve cell, having the dendrites, cyton and axons. Clear? So, you have to remember three things. In the nervous system, two things are found. That is the brain. Suppose, in our body, the total nervous system is divided into three parts. One is the central nervous system. The nerve organs which are present in the center of the body, like your brain and the spinal cord. Spinal cord, they are the central nervous system. They constitute the central nervous system. So the nerves which arise from the central nervous system, that is the brain and the spinal cord, they are called as the peripheral nervous system. They are called as the peripheral nervous system. Clear? And from the brain, that is the nerve which arises, they are called as the cranial nerves. And the, from the spinal cord, the nerve which arises, they are called as the spinal nerves. Then, cranial nerves and cranium, I have told you, just above the brain, the skull is present and the cavity which is formed, that is called as the cranium. According to that, that is the animals has been divided into two parts, that is called as the acraniata and the craniata. So those animals having the brain box, they are called as the craniata, and having no brain box, they are called as the acraniata. Clear? So here, the nerves which, that is arise
from the brain and proceeds through the cranial cavity into the other part. They are called as the cranial nerves. That is only 12 pairs. Clear? And the spinal nerves, that is which the nerves which arise from the spinal cord, and they constitute the peripheral nervous system, PNS, peripheral nervous system. And that is the central nervous system, is in short it is called as the CNS, central nervous system, which comprises of, that is, the brain and spinal cord. Another thing is that is called as the autonomic nervous system. Another thing is called as the autonomic nervous system, which comprises of sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. That is, so many things are there. That is, it will be taught to you at the time of nervous tissue or nervous system. Clear? Then, what are the sensory efferent or sensory nerves or neurons? The sensory neurons are the neurons which are connected between the sense organ, your eye is a sense organ, your skin is a sense organ, your tongue is a sense organ. That is the sense organ, between the sense organ with the central nervous system. The sensory neurons are connected between the sense organ to the central nervous system. And they brings the impulse from the sensory organs or sensory cell to the central nervous system. They are called as the sensory neuron or efferent neuron. The second one is called as the motor neuron. Motor. Or it is called as the efferent. Efferent neuron. The motor neuron, or it may called as the efferent neuron. Clear? That is, these neurons which are connected between, that is, the central nervous system and the effector or the target organ. So target organ, mainly the muscles and the glands. That is the target organs where it works. That is the neuron which carry the motor impulse from, that is, the central nervous system to the target organ. They are called as the motor neuron or efferent neuron. Clear? Then after, another neuron is called, that is called as the interneuron, or that is called as the adjuster. Interneuron or adjuster. Number three, interneuron or that is adjuster. Clear? Adjuster. That means, if you take the cross section of spinal cord, the spinal cord tracks of the brain sadiki, then ame kon koiba like this. Here, suppose this is the sense organ. Here, from the sense organ, the dendrites receives the impulse and bring it into the, that is, the cyton. And from the cyton, the axon arises and which proceeds into the central nervous system. This is the TS of spinal cord. Spinal cord. Here it ends here. The axon ends here. Then the adjuster or interneuron is present within the central nervous system. Within the central nervous system. It is central nervous system bhitre ye interneuron ta rahibo. Eta gote nua bohu bhalia kaam karibo. Karan ye central nervous system bahare rahibo nahi. Brain kimba spinal cord ra bahare rahibo ni. This is called as the adjuster. Aau ye kon karibo? Eutu nabo, eitu puni chhadi dabo. Eti aau gote neuron thibo, motor neuron, se kon karibo? Aku neikiri jibo. That is axon sahajare eta ku neiki jibo kouti ki na to the muscle. Suppose this is the sense organ, and it is the that is the motor neuron. And this is efferent or sensory neuron, and this is motor neuron or efferent. Clear? It is motor neuron or efferent. So, suppose it is skin or chi, sense organ, it mosa kamudila. Then it will transmit that, this is the sensation, will transmit into the, that is through the efferent or sensory neuron into the central nervous system. Then after, here the interpreter or the interneuron is present, which interpret and analyze the, that is the impulse, and then it directs, that is the motor neuron to act. So, the motor neuron will act here, as a result of which the muscle will contract and it will beat the, that is the mosquito. Tana eti mosa kamudila, se sensation ta eti ke asila, interneuron kon karibo, na taku grahan karibo, au taku analyze karibo, kariki aku order dabo, ye kon karibo, taku sarago kama karibo. So, this is called as the sensory, ba efferent, it is called as the, that is the adjuster or interneuron, and this is called as the motor neuron. So, e prakare sense organ or that is the nervous system kama karithai. Hala? So, and mainly this interneuron is present in the, that is the distant, that is the objects. Clear? So, in this way, the neurons are functionally of, that is the three types. One is a sensory efferent neuron, another is the motor or efferent neuron, another is the interneuron. So, this is all about the neurons. Then you come to the nerve fibers. Then you come to the nerve fibers. So, what is the nerve fibers? So, what is the nerve fibers? Nerve fibers are the branching process of the cyton, whether it may be the dendrites or the axon, covered by one or two or three covering or sheath, that is called as the nerve fiber. Nerve fiber kiye na seta dendron hei pare kimba axon hei pare, dendrite hei pare kimba axon hei pare, ta upare gutte kimba dita kimba tinta layer of covering thibo, and it will forms the nerve fiber. But specially the emphasis is given to the axon, to the axon, because for its long size or long structure. Clear? Mainly etaku efferent upare na axon upare diya huchi karana yara long structure achi. Clear? Then these fibers are structurally different, they are of a different, that is etaku di bhagare vyakta karaichi. One is medullated nerve fiber, another is non medullated nerve fiber. Nerve fibers are divided into three parts, into two parts, that is the, they are of two types. One is medullated nerve fibers, another is non-medullated nerve fibers. Medullated nerve fibers and another is non-medullated nerve fibers. So, what is the structure of medullated nerve fibers? Medullated nerve fibers, here it comprises of three things. It is intact in such. Guta hochi axis cylinder, the center rekhi hochi na axis cylinder. At the center there is axis cylinder. This is called as the axis cylinder. And above that is a thick layer is present, or thick sheath is present, that is called as the myelin sheath or medullated sheath. Myelin sheath or medullated, that is the fiber, that is the medullated sheath. Clear? Or the medullated sheath, or you can say medullary sheath. Then above that there is another Then above that, another thin layer is present, covering is present, which is called as the myelin sheath, which is called as the myelin sheath. Or myonil. That is neurolemma, which is above that, which is called as the neurolemma. So the neuronema, that is called as the neurilemma or neurilemma. Clear? The three things are present. The first one is called as the axon cylinder. Axon cylinder. The axon cylinder is nothing but your, that is the dendrites or the projection of dendrites or the axon. The axon cylinder is nothing but that is the axon, the axis cylinder is nothing but that is the projection, a simple projection of the dendrites or the axon from the cyton. Clear? Which contains the neurofibrils and the mitochondria, not the, that is the ribosomes and your, the, that is the Golgi bodies and the fat, etc. So it is called as the axon cylinder, and the cytoplasm is called as the exoplasm, and the membrane which covers it is called as the exolemma. And just on the exolemma, the, that is the impulse is traveled just through the exolemma. On the exolemma, the impulse travels. And above the exolemma, there is a thick sheath is present, that is called as the myelin sheath. And it is made, it appears as a white, shining, thick structure and made up of, that is the water, protein and lipid. And it is called as the myelin sheath. But the myelin sheath is not continuous, it is discontinuous in certain places, and that is called as the nodes of Ranvier. Node of Ranvier. Clear? The node of Ranvier. So the portion of the nerve fibers in between the nodes of Ranvier is called as the internode. Is called as the internode. So the, that is the neurolemma, which is a layer consists of the cytoplasm and the nucleus of the Schwann cell, of the Schwann cells, or you can say that is they are the Schwann cell or sheath cell, which produces the myelin, which forms the myelin just below that. And the neurolemma is continuous just above the dust, that is, it's continuous above the nodes and internodes. And each Schwann cell is restricted, that is, within an internodes, within an internode. So the Schwann cells or sheath cells are arranged, that is, one after another, or at the, that is, end to end. Tamane emte lomba bhitre eitara gote Schwann cell rahibo eutya tika puni ta upare eita node thibo, eita node thibo ta pare aro aute node bhitre eta rahibo, node internode bhitre eta rahibo, hala. That is called as the Schwann cell, or that is the sheath cell, which, that is, produces the myelin. Myelin is a thick, white, fatty cover-like structure just above the, that is, the axis cylinder. Axis cylinder, which is produced or which is synthesized by the Schwann cell. The Schwann cell, the cytoplasm of the Schwann cell, along with the nucleus, forms a continuous layer over the, that is, myelin, that is, medullated sheath or medullated or myelin. And the myelin is a not continuous, that is, the covering, it is a discontinuous at a certain places, and this is called as the node of Ranvier. So the, that is, a portion of the nerve fibers between the successive node is called as the internode. And that is the, since the Schwann cells forms the myelin, myelin. So this each sense, that is the Schwann cell, are restricted within an internode. Gutte Schwann cell, gutte internode bhitar rahibo. So seita ko tiyari karibo myelin sheath.
So this is the tinta jinsa aschi, gutte hala axis cylinder, tapare asala myelin sheath, ta upare rahila, that is the neurolemma. So in case of the central nervous system re kon hai chi na neurolemma is absent, then the that is the medullated sheath of, and it appears that is the medullated sheath or medullated nerve appears as white in color because the presence of the myelin sheath or the medullated sheath. Clear? And this medullated sheath contains the fatty, more fatty substances, so it appears as a white. But in case the medullated nerve fibers present in the brain and the spinal cord having no neurolemma, tadhara neurolemma nahi. Tenu neurolemma na rahile tankara regenerative power kami jibo. Tenu brain kimba spinal cord re jodi kichi injury huye tale taro recovery hatat hobo nahi. Our recovery hobo nahi. Clear? So this is the myelin sheath, and here the medullated sheath, actually the medullated sheath mainly kamo kon korchi, it is more present in the that is the nerves of it is present in the peripheral nerve system. Clear? It can't coruji. Now it behaves as an insulating layer which do not permit that is the lateral transmission of that is the impulse. Jadaraki lateral impulse jaunai. Jimiti amro electric wire, jodi amagute electric wire, jodi gute current jibo, ta upreze the rubber thibo, tale etar thick porimale currenta jibo, outside ki besi current nosto koribo, nahi. Jodi covering ochi, jodi covering nahi, tale our power aste komijibo, outside ki nosto hijibo kono, tar sobu electron transmit hobo. Simiti iti jo medullated sheath it behaves as an insulator which do not permit the site transmission. It helps the transmission of impulse in a straight way, that is from one neuron to the another neuron through the synapse. So this is the neurolemma and this is the medullated fibers in that is the brief. Then you come to the non-medullated nerve fiber. In the non-medullated nerve fiber, only that is the axis cylinder represent, and there is no that is the myelin sheath. Only that is the your neurolemma is present. Only neurolemma is present, and it appears as gray in color. In case of the brain and spinal cord, that is the brain and the spinal cord are formed of two things. That is, suppose the brain and this is the spinal cord. And the brain and the spinal cord are formed of two things. That is, the brain outwardly it is formed by the gray matter and inwardly it is formed by the white matter. And there is a cavity at the center that is called as the ventricle. Similarly, that is the white matter is present outside the in outer region of the spinal cord, and the gray matter present inside the that is the spinal cord. This is called as the gray matter. But in case of the brain, the gray matter present outside and the white matter present inside. Clear? The arrangement is alternate or in opposite. Then in the the white matter generally formed by the medullated nerve fibers as well as the cyton, dendrites and the axon hillock. So these
things forms along with the, that is the white medullated nerve fibers, it forms the, that is the gray medullated nerve fiber, non-medullated nerve fibers, it forms the gray matter, it forms the gray matter. And the white matter of the brain is formed by the, that is only the white, that is the medullated nerve fibers, clear? Then you come to, that is the, you come to, that is the polarity, neuron polarity. That is neuron polarity. Neuron polarity means that is in which way the, this is one neuron, in which way the transmission passes. It is called as the neuron polarity. Actually, always that is the impulse travels in one direction. That is first it is the impulse is received by the dendrites. Then it enters into the cyton, and from the cyton it is discharged through the axon. So that is, this polarity is called as the neuron polarity. In one end, through the dendrites, it receives the impulse, and through the, that is the axon, that is it discharges the impulse. So this is called as the, that is the polarity of the neurons. Then you come to the, that is the, this is all about the, that is the nerve fibers. Then you come to the, that is the types of nerves. The nerves are mainly two types. One is, the mainly the nerves are of two types. One is the efferent nerve, another is the motor nerves. One is efferent nerves, another is the motor nerve. What is, that is the, suppose this is the brain and this is the spinal cord. So the nerve fibers which brings the impulse, this is nerve fibers which brings or which connect between the sense organ with the nervous, that is the central nervous system, they are called as the sensory neurons. And here that is the nerve fibers, that means which brings the impulse from the different, that is sensory organ to the nervous system, they are called as the separate, that is the sensory called as sensory nerve fibers or efferent nerve fibers, which carry the impulse from the sense organ to the central nervous system. This is the sense organ and this is the central nervous system, CNS. So these are called as the efferent or sensory nerve fibers. Fiber, are you understanding? Fiber is a projection of the fiber. Eta hyper, dendrite hyper, kimba, axon hyper. Kintu specially, ame emphasis do chu kahaku na axon ku. Karan axon ta huche bodo. So those fibers which are connected between the sensory organs or sensory cell with the central nervous system, they are called as the sensory nerve fibers, which brings the impulse from the sensory organ to the nervous, central nervous system. But those taking the impulse away from the central nervous system to the target organ, they are called as the motor neurons, motor nerve fibers. Then you come to, that is the nerve. This is called about the nerve fibers. This is nerve fibers, and especially we are giving the emphasis over the, that is the axon. Then you come to the, then you come to the nerve. That when you come to the nerve, it is that insa tumko confusion kare. Kon kare? Na guta huchi nerve fiber, auta hala nerve. Nerve fiber kie? Na eguda hala nerve fiber, dendrites au axon eguda hala nerve fiber. So what is the nerve? Nerve actually, nerve is the combination of nerve fibers. Emti gudai misile gute nerve tiyari hobo. Eta gudai misile gute nerve tiyari hobo. So that is actually the nerves are formed by a bundle of nerve fibers. The bundle of nerve fibers. So this is, suppose this is the nerve fibers. Clear? Nerve fiber upare kie rahila na neural MR, that is called kie rahila na neural MR rahila. That is the, which is, that is the Schwann cell. Ta upare gute chutiya patala areolar connective tissue achi, taku kahanti endoneurium, taku kahanti endoneurium. So endoneurium kon kare na it helps to attach among the nerve fibers. Nerve fiber manku judiki rokkhibare sahajya kare. So these are the nerve fibers which are held together by or which are bind together by their own endoneurium. Endoneurium. Endoneurium is a connective layer, connective tissue layer, and it forms a large number of bundles, and these bundles are called as the fasciculus. Fasciculus. And the singular is fasciculus, and the plural is fasciculi. The plural is fasciculi. When a number of fasciculi are held together by another band of connective tissue, that is called as the perineurium. Perineurium. Then just above that is a white fibrous connective tissue layer is present, that is called as the epineurium. That is called as epineurium. And this epineurium contains the blood vessel. This epineurium contains the blood vessels. Then this epineurium contains the blood vessel, and the epineurium contains the fat which cushions the neuron. जेटा कि neuron को गद्दी भलिया काम करके ताको shape दे छि. That is, either a fatty body अच्छी, fatty tissue, fats is present. If the fats are absent, then it creates the pressure on the neuron or the nerve, as well as it makes the paralysis. यदि ये फैटटा रहइबो नाही ताले ए जो न्यू नर्व गडा रहिला ता ऊपर प्रेशर पड़िबो आ ए नर्व कोन करइबो ता बेले बेले उडा पैरालिसिस होबार चांस अछि हला. देन यू कम टू द टाइप्स ऑफ नर्व्स वी हैव दैट इज सीन दैट द नर्व फाइबर्स आर टू टाइप. वन इज सेंसरी, अनदर इज द मोटर. जणे आणुचे जणे नौचे फाइबर उडा. किंतु नर्व अछि तीन प्रकार. नर्व कोन sensory, motor, and mixed. That is sensory, motor, and mixed. ये तीन ही प्रकार है. Sensory कौन? ना if that nerve is made up of nerve टा कौन? The combination of nerve fiber. Nerve fiber कौन? That is these are either the dendrites or the axon. Mostly they are axon. Clear? Their one axon is called as one nerve fiber. But what is nerve? Combination of more axons and more dendrites, they are called as the nerve. And it is nerve, sensory nerve. Sensory nerve means it is the combination or it is formed by the combination of only the sensory nerve fibers. By the sensory nerve fibers, and it helps to bring the impulse from the sensory organ to the central nervous system. Clear? That is called as the sensory. Dhara mona kara eta 100 ta nerve fiber dwara tiyari, and all the 100 are sensory in nature. That is the 100 nerve fibers are sensory in nature. Another is the motor, which takes away the impulse from that is the central nervous system into target organ or into the that is the effector. Either it is the muscle or it is the that is the glands. Clear? So this is called as the motor. It is combination. Suppose it is that is the formed of 100 nerve fibers, so all are motor. Then another is mixed. Mixed what? Mixed means that is it is suppose this is 100, it may be combination of 25 plus 75 or 50 plus 50 or anything else. Clear? That is among them some are sensory and some are motor. Some are sensory and some are motor. So in this way, this is called as the motor nerve. Sensory nerve, that is mixed nerve. This is called as the mixed, the motor nerve and mixed nerve. Then you come to that is the, this is all about the neurons. So other things which are present, they are called as the neuroglia. They are present, and that is the ependymal cell, and that is the neurosecretory cells. Are they are behaving as the supporting as well as the protecting the neurons. So these are not so important. Clear? So that is, you can read yourself. So there is no time to teach them. Clear? These are very simple things, they are helping. But this is the most important, that is the neuron which have, that is which I described detail. Clear? So thank you to all. With this, the animal tissue is finished.